girls, four cities, and a whole lot of takeouts.
Oh, boy. This is your chance to get a taste of some of the great eateries of Placer County. Lori Wallace live with some details and plates of food.
Lori Wallace got some chicken.
Yes. With some chicken. Good morning, you guys. Wow, that was quite the intro, Coach. Placer Valley Eats kicks off tomorrow in Roseville, and you can log on to the website, print all the menus for all the different restaurants that are participating. I am at Bennett's this morning, one of those restaurants. They went all out. Would you look at all the food that Brian put together?
That's a lot of food.
This looks amazing. Brian, this is so cool. You're a part of Placer Valley Eats, and this is a huge help for restaurants locally.
Yep. It allows people to give us a try, to help us out, to get us jump-started. So as we come out of this COVID kind of containment, people can see what we do and help us out. We appreciate it.
Yeah, and you're lucky. You have a great patio here, but you also can do indoor seating now here in Placer at a limited capacity so people can come in or take it to go. And you have created these family meals that I'm really into. Let's talk about those.
Okay, so we have the cheeseburger meals, five cheeseburgers. They're all designed to feed four. Vegetable enchiladas, chicken enchiladas. They come with salads and chips and salsa. The next one over is our carnitas meal. It comes with beans and pico de gallo and sour cream and fresh tortillas. And then the last two are the fried chicken and then the rotisserie chicken. They all come with salad, some kind of starch, your choice, usually between french fries and mashed potatoes. And they're priced from $20 to $40.
Wow, all of a sudden you guys in the building are wishing, gosh, I really wish Lori still came into the building.
Yes.
I really wish she was coming back.
We say that
all of a sudden, right? So I have Wendy with the Roseville Chamber here to talk about this. This was a collaborative effort between all of the local chambers. Tell me a little bit about why you guys decided to do this.
So it was the Lincoln, Loomis, Rockland, and Roseville Chambers who couldn't sit idle and watch our businesses die on the vine. We said we needed to do something. So it was actually Tom from the Lincoln Chamber who came up with the idea of having a month-long opportunity for our residents to support our local businesses. And hence, Placer Valley Eats was born and is launching tomorrow.
Yeah, so Roseville through Sunday, and then you guys will be featuring other restaurants around the area as the weeks go on.
Yes, so the following weekend is in Rockland, then we have Lincoln, and we'll wrap up with Loomis the first weekend in October.
And why do you think this is so important for your restaurants? I know here in Placer, again, there is limited capacity for indoor seating, but there have been so many pivots throughout COVID that there are a lot of restaurants in this area that are suffering.
They are suffering. And when we started with this idea, we weren't sure when we were going to get the go ahead to reopen. And again, reopening is at a limited capacity. So we offered the opportunity to get your food to go, support your local businesses, and show them that you're here for them, not just this weekend in Roseville and the following weekends, but year-round, because they are suffering and they need all of us to support them. And we're all hungry.
And we're all hungry. We're even hungrier now with this bread. Thank you so much, Wendy. Cody and John, I'm in your backyard. This can be dinner tonight, done and done, all weekend long. Take out, support your local restaurants. What a great idea and a great way to get them back on the map during COVID. I'll send it back to you guys.
It is also a great idea for you to take that rotisserie chicken and drop it off at my house.
Wow.
Yes. I'll take the fried chicken and the carnitas.
You want to know something?
Mm-hmm.
You want to know something?
Yeah.
Scott Holcomb said the truck isn't big enough to bring any of this back. Now who's at the bottom of your list? Now who's at the bottom of your list?
I don't like Holcomb. He's a mean, tall man.